Brett Devine, we got through the championships and boy, what a great day racing.
Wasn't it fantastic, Tim? And we really hope all the members out there were tuned in and had a few bets and a bit of fun at home. They dressed up. It was four big group ones, and of course the international side of things of Sydney racing are really shining through now. The world was watching and the world was winning here at Royal Randwick on Saturday with a day of in the Longines Queen Elizabeth Stakes. A phenomenal achievement to have Sydney racing being broadcast around the world and seen, but also the participants here, and what a special day it was.
We're just about to go behind the barriers with Mark Newnham, had a great win with Splintex on the weekend.
Wasn't that a fantastic win too? It sat deep and hard on the pace, and he just kept finding, even though some people doubted he'd get the 1200. Mark, what a fantastic trainer. We're really looking forward to hearing him exclusively here for Australian Turf Club members today. And not only a great guy, but a really good trainer.
It's Splintex in front of Anaheed. Splintex a half to Anaheed, and then came Flit. Splintex still in front from Flit, who's surging on the far side. Flit goes to Splintex. They're wide apart. It's a photo in the Arrowfield. The fast finishing Flit and Splintex hit it together.
It is time to go behind the barriers. Mark Newnham, how are you?
Yeah, very good, mate.
Let's start with Splintex, because it was a really good win in the Arrowfield.
Yeah, look, he's just a really genuine, you know, fast horse, you know, and he's right from day one, he's always had speed. He's just needed to mature a little bit, and he's done that now, and he capped it off with a Group 2 win.
We're just a few days away from Anzac Day, and there's a really interesting military story behind Splintex.
Yeah, look, his owner, Jeff Grimish, Jeff and Mary Grimish bred him, but Jeff's a Vietnam vet, and he likes to give his horses a military name, and a Splintex is something he actually carries around in his wallet. It's like a little small dart that's part of a mortar, and he said it saved him and plenty of other guys' lives.
And you could almost hear yourself cheering, I suppose, like there was very few of you here for the win.
Yeah, it was a bit strange. I was standing down there on the grass, and gave him a few cheers inside the furlong, and then I could hear my own voice echoing, and I quickly shut up. But anyway, I thought I might have even been beaten on the line, but Robbie got him home.
It was a really good autumn. It continues to be a good autumn for you. Shadow Hero in the Randwick Guineas.
Yeah, look, fantastic. You know, he was probably plagued by wet tracks after that, but we're lucky we struck early in the autumn, and he got the Randwick Guineas. And look, he's he's two Group 1 wins now, and he's a gelding and good sound gelding, so he's here to race, so hopefully we get a few more seasons out of him yet.
A few other horses done well. Quintessa?
Yeah, placing in the Oaks, fantastic. She's a filly I've always had a really good opinion of, but it's taken until she got to 2,000 metres to show her best form. So she was placed in the Adrian Knox, and then get a Group 1 placing now for her. So valuable when she does go to stud, but there's plenty ahead of her.
And Quackerjack won a Group 3. I love the name. Tell us about the name, and it was a good win, wasn't it?
Yeah, look, he was actually the first horse I bought, Magic Millions. So, and look, an ownership group who I've ridden for, and Frank Mittiger, who heads up that group, I rode his first ever racehorse. And Quackerjack, I was looking at yearlings there, and I was looking for a horse that, you know, might be able to go early and get back there for the race the following year. And by a good, you know, really good stallion in Not a Single Doubt, good reliable horse, and his family traces back to a really fast filly when I was a kid called Mother Duck.
Mother Duck.
And she won a stack of races, so that's where the Quackerjack comes in.
How much does it help that you ride your horses as well? You're well regarded, I know you're modest, but I can say one of the best track riders there's been. You're a jockey yourself. How much does it help you to tune in to your horses?
Oh, look, I think it's a point of difference for me to other trainers, and look, I still enjoy doing it. It gives me the final say, if you like, on what I think of a horse. And look, and I'm not always riding the best horses. Quite often it's the horse that's not doing well or may have a problem, and you know, I'm doing my best to try and identify that. So yeah, it's the best ones you rarely have to ride, because they'll train themselves. But you know, the horse that might be giving you a bit of trouble, it might be the one I need to sort of find out a bit more about.
This was in your blood from a very young age, wasn't it? Because it goes back through your mother's side of the family, and your dad was a long-time journo.
Yeah, look, my grandfather on mum's side, he was a jockey and a trainer, and I've got a picture at home there. You think about it now, it's nearly 100 years old. It was the 1928 Victoria Park Cup, which was just over the back there at Zetland Victoria Park. And I think it's where there's a shopping centre there now. But and then he trained for a while as well. And then Dad was sporting editor at the Herald when I was a kid, so he was always off to the races every Saturday, and I'd tag along, and you know, he'd just let me run wild, you know, around the race course pretty much, and I'd come back and meet up with him every couple of races, and away I'd go.
And you went out of school strictly because you knew what you wanted to do. I wanted to go into horse racing, and you weren't even 15, were you?
I was just 15.
Just 15.
Yeah, and I was just 15, and I did work experience and then went into the school holidays, but I'd cleared my desk at school before I left, so I knew I wasn't going back. I'm not sure whether Mum knew. I think Dad had a good inkling, but I packed up and I started work here at Randwick when I was 15.
Isn't this just beautiful? A bluebird day. This place is phenomenal. Can you tell me about your love for Randwick?
I love coming to work here. You know, every morning there's something a little bit different on, but you know, it's got a great history in racing, Randwick, and I'm a little bit of a racing historian, and even when I'm doing my horse's form and setting a program for, you know, the better races, I go back through history on what's been the best path towards that. But no, Randwick, it's a special place, and you know, there's no better place to win a big race than Randwick.
And all the ATC courses have got their own bit of magic, don't they? Rose Hill, Warwick Farm, Canterbury on a Friday night.
Yeah, oh look, and Canterbury's the place where I rode my first ever winner. So, you know, there's a reason you enjoy every course, and they're usually around a win there. But look, you know, you get to slip a day at Rose Hill. You know, it's because it's a bit more compact, and the crowd gets, you know, right on top of the action there. There's always a buzz around for that, but. But when it comes to the, you know, the big group ones at Randwick, it's hard to beat.
You had to hold your breath when you went out on your own. A lot of unknowns when you'd say, well, I'm going in this direction. You'd work for people for a long time, you'd work for Gay. When you got that first group one, Maid of Heaven, Rachel King, it was her first group one. How do you reflect on that?
Yeah, look, now some of the things leading up to that, I look back now, I think, geez, that was a hard thing to do, but at the time you just got on and did it. And you know, I remember like the first 6 months of starting on my own, you know, you hardly have a runner, you know, you're working your backside off with not much return, money's going out. Look, then you get a steady flow of runners and winners, and you start to win a little bit better race here and there. And Maid of Heaven had no luck the week before in the Flight Stakes. She drew barrier one. James McDonald rode her, and he came back glowing in his report, and I mentioned to him that we might back up the following week, and he said, oh look, you're mad if you don't. She's run right through the line today, and he had another ride, and we waited till acceptance time, and I'd had a bit of luck with Rachel already on a horse called Lanciato. And I spoke to John Massara, and he said, well, who would you pick? And I said, Rachel, and he was happy to back her as well. And she gave a faultless display and got the job done.
By name and nature, Maid of Heaven that day, absolutely.
Oh, look, it was. And look, all the way up the straight, I thought she's got them covered, and then Arameo come up her inside, and it was only really a bob of the head, but, you know, big difference to me.
Lanciato, you mentioned. Finally, you got three chances on Saturday, another big day of racing.
Yeah, look, he's been a fair while off the scene. A few issues for an older horse, but he's come back in really good form. His first up run here behind Quackerjack was good. He's about 6 weeks between runs, which that's never been an issue for him. He does go well when he's fresh, but it's more the ground that helps him. And look, with this sort of sunshine at Randwick today and the next couple of days, hopefully we get onto a good track and he's ready to bounce back.
And you've got a couple of other starters, Graceful Glamour.
Yeah, looks really consistent filly and mare now. You know, Group 1 place, Group 3 winner. She's in the type of race that suits her. She's up to 2,000 metres. She'll bowl up on the pace and do a thing there. And I've got a good, really good emerging horse called Gone By. He's only had five starts. He's won three times, and he's actually owned by the lady who runs our office and her family. They bred him, and so the pressure's on there. But he's doing the job, and he won well at Warwick Farm the other day. He's up in grade, but he's a horse that's got a good future.
If you want your office to be run one, yeah, that horse needs to win. Look, thanks for going behind the barriers for the Australian Turf Club, Mark.
No, anytime, Tim. Thank you.
Mark Newnham, just soul of the earth. I love talking to him.
Yeah, great guy, and what a talented horseman, not only as a jockey, now as a trainer. Of course, he rides his own horses, as he touched on there, but really looking forward this Saturday, Tim, to another day of Group 1 racing. It's the Schweppes All-Age Stakes, always one of the strongest races of the year, and the Moet and Chandon Champagne Stakes, the final leg of the Triple Crown. Members out there, grab a bottle of Moet and Chandon and sit at home and enjoy the races again. We're obviously missing you, but this is very important. You can see today we've got a race day on protocols where we still have to wear our wristbands, but look, really appreciative of the members and of their support, and big day of Group 1 racing on Saturday, Schweppes All-Age Stakes.
Can't wait for it.